Hello, welcome to the Bruder Real Estate Team video blog. I'm Veronica Bruder, and today we're going to be talking about how to set the best price for your home. Here are four things that you must do. Number one is to avoid overpricing. You must price your home correctly and competitively, and you must do this from the beginning of your listing. This is a crucial step in selling your home. Not only selling your home, but selling your home quickly and getting the best possible price. Now, you can see what happens when you overprice versus correctly price your home. Correct pricing will get you the most showings and then offers to buy. As overpricing increases, you get decreased number of showings and almost no offers. Now, the temptation for many sellers is to overprice their home to start and then decrease the price if it doesn't sell. Unfortunately, this strategy is incorrect. By the time a seller realizes their price is too high, they have lost most valuable time to sell their home. This chart shows how the number of showings falls off as the time on the market increases, and how your best time to sell is during the first 6 weeks after listing. Continually lowering the price will actually turn off potential buyers who start to wonder what's wrong with your home. Your home becomes stigmatized and there are little to no showings. Number two. You must use hard data to set your asking price. You need to evaluate all of the prices comparable. This includes sold homes, the currently listed homes, and even those homes that have failed to sell. These are all of your competition. All of this must be looked at in the light of the current market status to arrive at a final listing price. Your pricing strategy needs to be in sync with your realtor. But you should personally check the internet and be prepared to bring your own educated input to the decision. You should price your home only after this analysis. An additional factor is the current housing market status. For example, Las Cruces is currently in a strong seller's market where demand from buyers outpaces the number of homes for sale. You may be able to price your slightly higher than market value and still be attractive to buyers. Number three, don't assume renovations, repairs, and home improvements should result in a dollar-for-dollar increase in the selling price. Now, that's not easy to say that they aren't worth it, but realistically, even those upgrades which are important generally only return about a percentage of the actual cost. And number four, keep your head in the game. You must be willing to adjust the price when needed. The ultimate price test is how buyers react. The way to tell if you priced too high is if you are getting few showings and no offer. If your competition is selling and you are not, you're probably overpriced. At that point, you must be realistic and adjust your price. Thank you for watching this video blog. Feel free to contact us at any time, for we are happy to help you with any questions you may have.